Lil Jan's great grand. No.
Well, I heard that, but she didn't have it, so.
You're right.
You're
gorgeous. Opening back to
your seat. So I think it's very nice to have this in our worship experience as we approach the time of prayer in our service each and every week. The pastoral prayer is not just for the pastor. Really, it is your prayers, the prayers of the people. I just am the one that leads in that prayer. And we want to hear what prayer requests you might have. And the first one that I want to lift before you is for our Nancy Marshall, who is in the Albany Hospital. And she wanted to make sure that we all knew that she was there and that we prayed for her. So it's going to be a privilege to lift her. She did, Kathy, I think, have some stroke symptoms. And so we want to pray for her doctors. We want to pray for Nancy to be encouraged through this bump in the road, as I sometimes say. So in addition to Nancy, we of course want to continue to remember Keith Fleshman, who I was able to see this last week, the Campbells, and Dee Dee Blay is still under the weather with COVID. Shanna's great aunt passed away this week in Milton Freewater. Her name is Gwen Zimmerman. So we want to remember Shanna, your family, and the Zimmerman family. We have many in our community and beyond that are experiencing the new strains of COVID, including our president. So we want to remember all of those affected. Many people are being affected by the heat wave. Now, we've had a nice cool day or two, but watch out. Here it comes. There's a heat wave through much of our country, wildfires in California and Idaho, Montana. There are those that are continuing to go through bereavement, even in our church family. And we want to pray today for our pastoral search committee, our interim transition support committee, and all the various committees and teams of our church. This is a busy place, and there are lots of meetings going on with a lot of good work, as Nadine says so regularly. A lot of good work they are all doing, and that they will continue to do in the weeks and months to come. Are there any other prayer requests that any of you would like to lift? Mary Dale.
Very good friends of mine in Texas, Jan and Patrick Butler, and their entire family all have COVID.
Jan and Patrick Butler in Texas, their whole family has COVID. We remember them. Other prayer requests that you would feel comfortable
sharing? I just got an announcement from Amanda. She's going to have a kidney
donation?
No, a kidney
transplant.
No, yeah, the kidney transplant. She's going to
transplant.
Yes.
And that's Amanda?
Yeah, my friend.
Okay, we'll remember her. Any other requests? If not, let's lift all of these in a time of quiet prayer before God, and then I will be privileged to lead us. Loving God, prayer is the very foundation of our lives as Christians. Because when we pray, we are in relationship with you. And that is what you desire. Thank you, dear God, for being with all of those that have been mentioned this morning. Nancy Marshall, as she goes through this time of recovery in the hospital, lift her spirits. Be with her doctors and nurses. We thank you for her life of faith, her life that means so much to all of us. For the Campbells and the Fleshers, for the Butlers in Texas, for Amanda, for the Zimmerman family and Shanna's family, all of these that are going through difficult times and challenges of health and bereavement, we lift each and every one before you. We love you, O God, and we thank you for your great love for all of us, and for the church and for what it means to us. We pray, O God, for the countless individuals that are continuing to be affected by COVID. We pray for Dee Dee this morning, that you would help her to feel better. We pray, dear God, for those that are affected by the heat wave. The heat wave that is coming yet again to our area. For all of those affected by the wildfires. And how we remember when the wildfires were so close to us here. Loving God, we pray for our church in this time of transition. We're so thankful for the committed members and friends of this church, for those that serve on teams and committees and transitional teams. And we especially pray for the work of our future pastoral search committee as they search for the right person to come and to be our next pastor. Loving God, we would ask that you would be with the many travelers in our church during this time, during these summer weeks and months. Grant them safety and grant them times of renewal during this summer. We love you, dear God, and we lift this prayer and all of our prayers in the name of Jesus, who has taught us to pray, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Once Jesus was in a certain place praying. As he finished, one of his disciples came to him and said, "Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples." Jesus said, "This is how you should pray. Father, may your name be kept holy. May your kingdom come soon. Give us each day the food we need, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And don't let us yield to temptation." And then teaching them more about prayer, he used this story. Suppose you went to a friend's house at midnight, wanting to borrow 3 loaves of bread. You say to him, "A friend of mine has just arrived for a visit, and I have nothing for him to eat." And suppose he calls out from his bedroom, "Don't bother me! The door is locked for the night, and my family and I are in bed. I can't help you. But I tell you this, though he won't do it for friendship's sake, if you keep knocking long enough, he will get up and give you whatever you need because of your shameless persistence. And so I tell you, keep on asking, and you'll receive what you ask for. Keep on seeking, and you will find. Keep on knocking, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks, receives. Everyone who seeks, finds. And to everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. You fathers, if your children ask for a fish, do you give them a snake instead? Or if they ask for an egg, do you give them a scorpion? Of course not. So if you sinful people know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask Him?
I love that translation, Chad. What a great job reading that, too. Yes. There could be some humor at times in the Bible, right? Well, last week we were reminded that as we go through this time of transition, in faith, in hope, and yes, some worry at times, we were reminded that Christ is in us. Christ is with us through all of this time. And now, this morning, from the Gospel of Luke, we're reminded that prayer is the critical part in all of life, and especially through the transition of our lives. I'm sure we could stop right now and you could all tell a story about how prayer has been such a critical part at some times or another in your life. Christ is with us. I want you to believe that. Christ is in us. He is. And prayer is our foundation. Prayer, however, is so different for many. Some of us think our prayers, do we not? Some of us are in a constant communion with Creator God. Some of us pray when we think about it. There may still be some that go into that bedroom closet and close the door. I will never forget the late Hartzell Cobbs preparing the church for prayer one morning with these words, words that you have sung in this church. Prayer is the soul's sincere desire, uttered or unexpressed, the motion of a hidden fire that trembles in the breast. I remember Hartzell's dramatic way of reciting those words. In fact, so much so that one could almost hear a pin drop. As your in-between pastor, I want to urge you yet again, as Albany's First Christian Church Disciples of Christ, to pray in whatever way you pray for our transition, for our leadership, for the Pastoral Search Committee, and those which will represent this body in its best and in its truest form. For the candidates that are already being stirred to consider coming here and leading with you, this church, into the great and unknown decades ahead. Yes, decades ahead. To add on to the already 140 years that this church has been in existence, and the 2,000 years that the Christian church has been in existence. You see, we have always been a part of something great and much greater than we are. So much of church has been out of our hands as our world has experienced time and again a division and war. The Spanish influenza, where millions and millions and millions died. We were not the first at Albany First Christian Church to wear masks. You look back at our church records upstairs. They had to wear masks in 1918. And God forbid, may we not ever have to wear them again. But now, it's not chicken pox, but it's monkey pox. Have you heard about that in the news? So much continues to encompass our world in 2022. But prayer has been a part of it all from the beginning. And it begins again here in this text with Dr. Luke speaking to us. Prayer, you see, is the foundation. And Jesus is the one who has taught us to pray. Much of it based on the Jewish way, especially as we divide up the Lord's Prayer and we look at what is in there. Now, Chet read the New Living Translation. I think on the screen we had the New Revised Standard Version, of which some of you, many of you perhaps, use that. But it is perhaps one of the most used and read across the Christian church, at least in today's world. But as I listened to you pray, and as I listened to you pray just a few moments ago, many of you pray, "Our Father," even though the screen has been saying, "Our Creator." Now, I want to encourage you to pray however you learn that prayer. Not necessarily what might be on the screen. And to me, it is very personal how one individually addresses the supreme being of the universe. Father, Mother, Creator, Life Giver, Light, and yes, Supreme Being, Abba. We do not all have to pray in the same way, but if you ever wonder, how do I pray and what do I say, the prayer in our text this morning shows us the path. The many versions, translations, paraphrases of the Bible show us the path. You know, I've learned the hard way through ministry that I always just don't call on somebody randomly to pray, because not everybody is comfortable praying out loud. What if I called on you right now to pray? Just to stand up and pray. Would you feel comfortable doing that? But if I do call on someone and they are not comfortable praying out loud, I immediately cover. And it is usually all right. It usually works out. Several years ago, I had a longtime Christian asking me for help in praying a prayer for Christmas dinner. He would be the one that would do the praying on Christmas Day, and he was scared to do it. Prayer is the soul's sincere desire, utterly or unexpressed. I should say that I helped the gentleman, and all went well. The important thing is that we pray. The important thing is that we connect, because our purpose with Christ being in us is to be in relationship. We've not been created to be lone rangers on the rolling hills of eastern Montana. But when I would drive east from Billings, there would be no one for miles and miles and miles. But in the beauty of that big sky, there was still that still small voice. There was still God's greatness in all of its fullness. And that is what we are seeing these days in the vastness images of space, thanks to the new James Webb telescope. It's so critical that each one of us, as well as our church, be in relationship with God, with one another, and within the worlds where we live and work. Jesus had just visited Mary and Martha when one of his disciples asked him to teach them how to pray. Began by addressing the hallowedness of God. And again, Jewish prayers often began by addressing God as Father. The common Jewish prayer, called the Kaddish, begins with the exaltation and greatness of God's name. The one who has made us all in the world with a desire for God's kingdom to reign. And then bread, our daily bread. Even though many in our day and time no longer perhaps have a formal prayer at the dinner table, many still do. And not just Christmas dinner. God, you see, had provided daily bread in the form of manna for 40 years in the wilderness. We are taught to rely on God for our daily sustenance and to give thanks for what we have. I'm sure many of those that come to our church door through the week are hungry, and they too are relying on God and praying that God will make possible a snack pack through our church ministry. We give out a lot of those. But this last week, someone came to the door that was different. And this individual needed a ride to go get a check cashed. The bus wouldn't be coming by for another hour and a half. But the bottom line was this: hunger hunger. He was hungry. It's a terrible thing to be hungry. Something that most of us have never fully endured. Perhaps back in the Great Depression, although most of you are too young to have even been through the Great Depression. Maybe it was when you were in college and you were a broke college student. Then comes that all-important part of the prayer that Jesus is teaching here, teaching us again this morning. Forgiveness. In the regularly prayed Jewish prayer, the Amidah, it is a prayer of forgiveness. God wants to forgive others even as He forgives you and He forgives me. And do not bring us to the time of trial, which means do not let us fail when we are tested. All of these things, you see, give us the foundation, and all of these things are interactive and relational. Jesus then gives an interactive example of how we should exude perseverance. The story about a friend going to another at the midnight hour with a request to borrow 3 loaves of bread. Now it's true in my ministry and perhaps yours, the phone has rung at my home at the midnight hour or later. But I don't recall it was ever for some loaves of bread. But the moral of the story here is the persistence. A friend in the end will come through. A friend in the end will get up and give his friend whatever he needs. I urge you during this time of transition and change to let your prayers be persistent. Not just when you think about it. Persistent prayer is the foundation when Christ lives in us. Persistent prayer is the foundation as all of our various committees and groups and teams are coming together for the future of this great church. It's not just your individual committee. It's all of our committees working together at the same time. This last week I was so excited and privileged to see the visioning team report. And you will be receiving that report, I believe, by email or regular mail, perhaps this coming week or so. This visioning report information is wonderful. And it's so timely in the life and history of Albany First Christian Church. And I salute all of you for making that retreat happen. Those of you who were able to be present, those of you who shared one with another, and those of you who prayed for that retreat. The vision is the foundation where prayer bathes it all. This is the foundation that will take your church into the next decades to come. Yes, we're all aging. Yes, there are worries. Yes, we're not exactly sure how we are going to move forward as we work. Our society changes by the day. Our culture changes by the day. Our country, our state, our city. There are so many things that we cannot control. This last week before heading to Silverton, I don't remember exactly which day it was, but I stopped by the Albany Carousel. I was so impressed. And to hear the history, especially the inspiration when a lady named Wendy visited the carousel in Missoula, Montana. It was 22 years ago that I spent a two-month interim ministry with First Christian Church of Missoula, where the great Paul Dean Hill, no relation, had pastored, and then Dan Dixon. And I was able to visit the Missoula Carousel several times on the banks of the Clark Fork River. And then most recently, about 2 or 3 years ago, I visited the carousel in Helena. They've got a lot of carousels in Montana, did you know? But never would I dream that someone would visit and that an idea, a vision, would be planted for a marvelous addition to your community, this community, the city of Albany, Oregon. I'm sure that not only money was a part, but prayer, hope, dreams, visions of what this could be for children and adults in this community and beyond. I talked to a former secretary of this church last night, Becky Barnes. She was here in the early 70s. Long before that carousel was over there. So much changes through the decades. But life goes on, the church goes on, and this church can have the greatest future that it's ever had. I believe that. And so, no matter what you are worried about, no matter what you're facing in your life, whether it's aging, and now that I'm in my 70s, I'm thinking about aging a lot. Might be health issues. It might be questions about the future, where you're going to live, what are you going to do? God knows all. God sees all. God, your Father. God, your Mother. God, your Creator. God, the one great being, knows you and loves you. And He is that one that wants to be in relationship with you, with the foundation. So pray and pray again and again and again. Loving God, we love you. We look to you as our Father, our Mother, our Creator God, the one that has given all life, the one who has created this church, the one who has made it possible for us to be a part of this local church and your church around the world. And so as we go through this time of transition and change, may you remind us that you want to be in relationship with each of us. We pray, Creator God, for your will to be done in this church, in all the years and decades to come. How we thank you for the wonderful 140-year past. And as we look to celebrate 150 years in another 10 years, we pray and we believe that the best is still just ahead. May we be reconciled in your love, and may we experience your peace be a time that you would like to meet with one of our elders or leaders of the church for a time of prayer, we are always willing to pray with you. So let us be standing as we sing the first two verses of My Jesus, I Love You.
Thank you.
think that needs a round of applause. Thank you, Karen, so much. One of the great things about infant ministry for me personally is going to different churches and hearing music. We all love music, I think. I'm sure we do. But music is expressed in different ways in different places. And you certainly have a wonderful music leadership here. And I'm looking forward to perhaps this fall, not only the children singing, but some of you singing in the choir again, too. So we'll see what we might develop on that before I leave here. All right? So let me just say thank you for worshiping this morning. It's been great to have you in church today. For those of you watching online, please, if you're in the Albany area, come and join us in person, but continue watching online as well. I do have a few little announcements to make. First, the LGBTQ group will be meeting in about 5 to 10 minutes after the benediction in the Disciples Hall, and that will be a wrap-up from the recent Pride events in our community. And coming up this week, besides our regular meetings and prayer times and all of the activities of the church, we're having a night's game on Tuesday, Ryegram, and a garden tour this coming Saturday. The garden, we're going to be at the Pasecas, the Peckhams, Salston, Kalawatz, Monado, and Nancy Marshall. We'll see. How she's feeling, but her yard will still be there. Anyway, that should be fun. And then also this coming Saturday is Medicare's birthday. Now, I don't know about you, but I am grateful for Medicare. And there will also be a health care for all meeting this Saturday. So please pay attention to your weekly word that will come out tomorrow, I believe, and it will have all of these specifics coming up, starting a week from tomorrow, on which is August 1st. A week from tomorrow is August 1st. We have our regional youth camp at the Kaiser Christian Church, and the following Saturday, the FCC bike ride on August 6th. So lots of fun things there. Places in the foyer for you to sign up and become a part of these activities. And also, yes, Jan.
I just want to announce that the financial statements for the second quarter are in the narthex. You can pick them up and save us a stamp.
Thank you, Jan and Charlotte, for your work on that. The financial statements for the second quarter available in the narthex, and so you may pick those up, and thank you for giving. Gary,
I just would like to let you know, last Sunday we had a fundraiser for Creating Housing Coalition of City Village, and thanks to a strong community support and support from this community, we raised
$353,000.
Wow.
Wow. Congratulations. Tell us also, Gary, what are some of the plans, the immediate plans for creating housing in the community? I'm fairly new here, so maybe everybody knows, but what are some of the things that you're going to be doing with that $353,000?
Of the congregations ahead of you in understanding.
I'm sure they are.
But so we are in the process of building a democratic self-governing community for extremely low income, unhoused people in Albany. So we will be putting up 27 tiny homes, permanent homes for people to live in who have low income or unhoused. And it will be following a different
Well, thank you, Gary, and all of you that are involved in this. We appreciate your leadership in ministering right here in our area and community. Thank you so much. Let's see. Rick, did you have a...
Yeah, that's a tough one to follow. I just wanted to clarify that this Saturday is not a meeting of the mission, the healthcare assistance mission. It's a rally in front of the courthouse at 11 to 12. So those who are not out in the garden partying, please join us. It should be a lot of fun.
All right.
And use it with a little speed as well.
Thank you so much, Rick, and for your leadership in those areas. We appreciate it.
Gene?
So much. Yes, Angela?
I mailed Alan Campbell a Get Well card, and I hope he got it. Mailed him a Get Well card.
Okay. Thank you for doing that. Any other announcements before we leave? All right. Let's be standing for our closing song and benediction.
Thank you. Well, the whole community is just so nice. I love the gym now. It's just really, just really.
Thank you both.